Okay, then I am taking some questions. First question is, find, this will be very good for your practice, all these problems. Domain of domain means you have to find solutions for the equation mod of x plus 3 plus x upon x plus 2 greater than 1. Different types of questions I will take, all different models. So this will be today basically your thorough revision of all the concepts. Just solve it. Those who have solved, just tell me. I will check it. See, now here is a problem is there in this question. If you observe carefully, in this mod is there. So first of all, right hand side is not zero. So what I will do, I will transfer everything on the left hand side. That means I will write this as a mod of x plus 3 plus x upon x plus 2 minus 1. Then I will take the LCM minus x minus 2. Upon x plus 2 greater than 0. Now this x will cancel this x. Then I will write that mod of x plus 3 minus 2 upon x plus 2 is greater than 0. Can you simplify this now? After what we must do? Let us see. There are two ways are there. One is very long way. That means if you simplify this mod first. Another is just to find the roots. That is what I told. We have to mark the roots on the number line. So what are the roots? In numerator, we have a mod of x plus 3 minus 2 is equal to 0. So this gives a mod of x plus 3 is equal to 2. So x plus 3 must be how much? Plus minus 2. 2 and minus 2. So x will be equal to minus 1 or minus 5. These are the two roots. And in denominator, you are having x is equal to this denominator. What is the root of this? X is equal to minus 2. X is equal to minus 2. So now on the number line, we will mark all these three roots. So now the roots are smallest root minus 5, then minus 2, then minus 1. Now check the sign scheme. What was the sign scheme method? Those students who have joined late, I have earlier also told they must inform me separately. They have my number. You must inform separately so that I can explain you separately. Okay, this scheme, if you have not learned the first, attended your first few classes, then you have to attend one extra class. For that, you have to inform me separately on to me my on my WhatsApp number. So here, if I put x anything more than 1, suppose I am putting x is equal to 0, any number, I'm not saying 0 only, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, check in the original equation. So 0 plus 3 mod plus 0 upon 0 plus 2 greater than 1. Sorry, not in this. You must put this in this equation when I need to check positive, negative. So x equal to 0, put in this equation, x equal to 0, where you will put? This I have to check whether it is positive or negative. X equal to 0 is giving positive or negative. That you have to identify. So the moment you put x equal to 0, what is the equation, in which equation we will put? This equation. This is my equation now. So 0 plus 3 mod minus 2 upon 0 plus 2. So this is equal to 3 minus 2 upon 2 is greater than 0. 1 upon 2 is greater than 0. That means this side it is positive, negative, alternate sign scheme. And what I need? Greater than 0. So answer will be x belongs to minus 5 to minus 2 union minus 1 to infinity. So I'm just unmuting you so that if any doubt is there, you can ask me. I've unmuted everybody. If you have any doubt, you can ask me.
One doubt is there. Why didn't you take the like plus 2 as the root?
What?
Sir, after x plus 3 modulus is equal to 2, you got two roots. X plus 3 is equal to 2 comma minus 2.
Yes.
So why didn't you take this thing, 2 as the root? You take...
No. See, suppose if I have, for example, if I have x minus 1 is equal to 5. So what value, what is the root of this? X minus 1 minus 5. Basically, it is minus 5 is equal to 0. If I ask what is the root of this, so what you will do? You will write mod of x minus 1 is equal to 5. And we know if mod x is equal to a, then x is equal to plus minus a. Next step will be, my logical step will be x minus 1 is equal to plus minus 5. So 5 and minus 5. So this gives me that x equal to 5 plus 1, 6. And minus 5 plus 1 is minus 4. So two solutions will be there. These are the roots of this equation. Understood?
Okay. Sorry.
No problem. Welcome. Any other doubt anybody having in this? Okay. Then write another question. Find the DOM or write this. Find the domain of y is equal to log 10 x minus greatest integer function x. Find the domain of this. One more question I'm taking. Find domain of y is equal to under root of log 0.3 3x minus x square upon x minus 1. Yes, correct. Pritha is correct. Infinity is never included, Pritha. Pavitra, because at plus infinity or minus infinity, we always have open interval because we can never reach infinity. That is the reason. And afterward, one more question I will be giving. So for this question, y is equal to log 10 x minus. So this x minus greatest integer function x, if you remembered one concept I have told, this x is equal to greatest integer function x plus fractional part of x. So from here, x minus greatest integer function x is equal to fractional part of x. And we know that fractional part of x is always greater than 0, less than 1. Now here lies one very important thing. Basically, now I will see analysis of this question, how we can analyze this question further in 2-3 ways. In this case, when I'm taking this direct problem, question y is equal to log 10 x minus greatest integer function, I am just simply writing fractional part of x. So fractional part of x is always positive, and we know that log x is always defined when x is, this concept I have already given, that log a x is always defined when x is greater than 0. And here this fractional part of x is always greater than 0. Only problem is fractional part of x must not be equal to 0. So x cannot be any integer. No, not 0 to 1. 0 is closed interval. Fractional part of x varies between 0 to 1. At integers, this will be equal to 0. So now for this particular case, this must not be 0. When this will be 0? When x is integer. So x cannot be any integer, set of integer. So my answer will be x belongs to all real number minus integers, r minus I, set of integers. This will be answer. But suppose, slightly, I change the question. Separate. Question number 1A. Suppose I change this. That means if I ask you, y is equal to under root of log 10 fractional part of x. Now, what will be the answer of this question? I have unmuted everybody. Anybody can give answer? See immediately how the question changes. There are some, I think, new students are there. Sehan. Your first class. And Rakshita, Prabha, Putra, Nas, Zer, Murari, Malakshmi, Krishna, Atti, Tanvi is there, good.
Sir, it is not defined.
Yes, good. Sehan, this is your first class. Can you tell me Sehan? S-A-Y-H-A-N, your name is S. So this is your first class, I think you may be finding it difficult. Don't worry, from next class we will start new topic. So this you can attend one extra class, okay? You must inform me separately. Okay? Yeah. It is not defined. The answer of this is not defined. Yes, very good. Murari also has done nicely, very nice. See here, what was the concept? Log 10 fractional part of x must be greater than equal to 0. Now the problem is, if you remember the here the log x graph, if you remember the log x graph, what was the log x graph? Was like this. This 0, 1, this side plus infinity. That means when x lies, if you can observe here, if x lies between 0 and 1, what is the log x giving you? Log x is giving this minus infinity to 0, downward side. When x lies, so this you can remember, learn in this way. If x lies between 0 and 1, because it cannot be 0, log x is greater than log 1, 0, and less than, greater than minus infinity. It is always increasing function. This is greater than minus infinity and less than 0. If x is more than 1, then this is always positive. This part you can see, upper part. If x is more than 1, this is positive, more than 1. But if x is negative, this is given by this red color part, this x is less than 1. That means when x varies between 0 to 1 from here to here, x varies between 0 to 1, this log, as base is more than 10, varies from minus infinity, this side minus infinity to 0. This will be equal to 0 at x equal to 1. And we can see this can never be 1 because it is fractional part of x. This is less than 1. So here answer will be, what will be my answer? X belongs to phi null set. X belongs to phi. Now come to this next problem. Y is equal to log of 3x minus x square upon x minus 1 to the base 0.3. See, all questions you must attempt. That is very, very important. The process is very important. Here, our focus must be first of all on under root. Under root fx. When under root fx is defined, when fx is greater than equal to 0, so here, first step must be this under root to be defined inside quantity log 0.3 3x minus x square upon x minus 1 must be greater than equal to 0. Remember, equal to is also there here. Now, inequality is there. Immediate your focus must be on the base. whether this base is more than one or less than one. If base is more than one, what I have told, there will be no change in the inequality. But if it is less than one, inequality will change. So next step will be 3x minus x square upon x minus 1 is less than 0.3 raised to power 0. 0.3 raised to power 0, that is 1. So we will transfer this 1 this side and take LCM. So next step is 3x minus x square minus x plus 1 upon less than 0. 2x minus x square plus 1 upon x minus 1 less than 0. Now see, I will multiply with minus sign. So if I multiply with minus sign, what I will get? X square minus 2x minus 1 upon x minus 1. Less than 0. Now this, you have to find the solution of this. What are the roots of this solution of this equation? So numerator, what are the roots? You can find the roots. X is equal to x square minus 2x minus 1 is equal to 0. X is equal to minus b plus minus under root b square minus 4ac upon 2a. So what is the root? X is equal to 1 plus under root 2 and 1 minus under root 2. These are the roots. And one root is x equal to 1. See, now method is very simple. Yes, inequality will change. I have not changed. I just spoken, but I have not changed the inequality. So inequality will change. This will become greater than equal to. So now mark all these roots on a number line. What are the roots? One root, 1 minus under root 2, this root is, and another is 1 plus under root 2. And if you put any large number, suppose 3, 4, 5, this will be always positive. You can check. So this will be plus, minus. And what I need here, greater than 0. So my answer will be 1 minus under root 2, this portion, and 1 to infinity, this. And x is not equal to 1, that you must write. X is not equal to 1. That you also must write. X is not equal to 1. So my answer will be closed interval 1 minus under root 2 to open interval 1. Union closed interval 1 plus under root 2 to infinity. This is clear? I'm unmuting all. If any doubt is there, you can ask me. Yes, any doubt? Shall I proceed further? Everybody has noted this?
So 1 minute.
Akshay?
Yes, sir.
Why you have not submitted any assignment from Google?
So I didn't receive the assignment. I told you about it.
On Google? No, now what you must do, you must download the Google Classroom.
Yes, I downloaded
it. In the classroom, okay?
I'm there,
yeah,
sir.
So in the classroom only, in the classroom only, you will get all the assignments.
Yeah, I clicked on the assignments. It's not opening. So can you send it to me separately if you can?
No, again, I will pass that on the assignment, okay?
Okay, sir.
Yes, Vyas. Okay, done. Okay. So no. Now come. Yes?
So why didn't we do 3x minus x squared by x minus 1 is greater than 0?
What?
Why didn't we do 3x minus x squared by x minus 1 is greater than 0?
3x minus x minus x square plus 1 upon. Oh, why I have done that?
No, sir. Why didn't we do 3x minus x square by x minus 1 is greater than 0?
3x minus x is how much? Vx so minus x is.
Shouldn't the expression inside a log be greater than 0? Why didn't we do that?
Yes. That also we must do. Less than 1 and it must be greater than 0. Yes, correct. Because in explaining, I forgot that. So, okay, I will do one thing. I will take this question on the next sheet. Okay. This is incomplete at this part. This is one part of this. So, in the next sheet, what we will do, I will covering this completely. This question. Okay. So next sheet I'm going, then you can see this more better way. Y is equal to under root of log 0.3 3x minus x square dx minus x square upon x minus 1 net. Yes. So in this, definitely every question, we must take two conditions. That first condition is here. Space was less. So because of that, I could not solve that there. So log 0.3 3x minus x square upon x minus 1 must be greater than 0. And at the same time, I must write that 3x minus x square upon x minus 1 also must be greater than 0. See, and this is the first condition. This is second condition. In first condition, equality is there. In second condition, there is no equality. Then we will have from here 3x minus x square upon x minus 1 is less than 1. Then take LCM 3x minus x square minus x plus 1 upon x minus 1 less than 0. So we are having here x square minus 2x minus 1 upon x minus 1 greater than 0. This we have done already. From here, we will get x into 3 minus x upon x minus 1 greater than 0 or x into x minus 3 upon x minus 1. Minus I have taken common less than 0. Now we will solve both. So in this case, we were getting the roots x is equal to, again, I'm solving this to check any mistakes, x is equal to minus b plus minus under root b square minus 4ac upon 2a. So 1 plus under root 2 and 1 minus under root 2. So in this case, my answer is here from this. This is 1 minus under root 2, 1 plus under root 2. And this, if I put large value of x is positive. So this will be plus minus. So in this case, my answer is greater than zero means 1 minus under root 2 to 1. So 1 minus under root 2 to infinity. But I have to check this sign also. This. So from here I will get second condition. Roots are 0, 1 and 3. 0, 1 and 3. So this is like plus, minus, plus, minus. Then what is the solution of this? Plus, minus, here what I need? Negative. Negative means this part, this part, this part. Negative means this part and this. Negative is here. And no equality here. So open intervals are there. All are open intervals. Now these two conditions I have to merge. These two conditions I have to merge to find the common solution. So you note down this part. I have to clean somewhere on this list so that I can explain it further. Okay, just note down this first. So this part I'm cleaning to explain it again. See, this is the final number line. Solution from this. First one. This is the first one. This is second one. From first one, solution is 1 minus under root 2. First mark all these line numbers on number line. 1 minus under root 2. 1 minus under root 2. After this, I will have 0. 1 minus under root 2 is negative number. Then I am having 1. After 1, I will have 1 plus under root 2 because under root 2 is 2.14. So under root 2. And after under root 2, 3 will come. I think this is the order. First is giving me 1 minus under root 2 to 1. 1 minus under root 2 to 1. 1 is open interval. 1 minus under root 2 to 1. This. And 1 plus under root 2. This is 1 plus under root 2. To infinity. So from here to infinity. This is the first one. Second one is giving me this black color. Second one. So second one is giving me minus infinity to 0. Minus infinity to 0 like this. Open interval to minus infinity. Then 1 to 3. This part. You can check this part. 1 to 3. Less than 0. 1 to 3. So 1 to 3. Both are open interval. 1, 2, 3. Now see what is the common part. That is the answer. So common part is this. And common part is this. So the answer will be x belongs to, I'm writing answer here. So x belongs to close interval 1 minus under root 2 to 0. Now we have to check whether 0 is open interval. Yes, 0 is the open interval. Union. 1 plus under root 2 to 3. 3 is open interval. This is the final answer. Of doing the second part. Yeah, I asked out. One minute, I'm unmuting.
Sir?
Yes? Yeah, ask, Ati.
In the first equation, first condition.
Yes.
We have to take it as 0 is less than 3x minus x squared divided by x minus 1 is less than equal to 1. So why do we neglect the 0, sir? Because when the log is less than 0, log is between 0 to 1, the condition is minus 1 is less than, 0 is less than x is less than 1. Why do we neglect 0?
No. Something we are missing here. 0 I have neglected because here we have root. 0 is root from where equation? 0 is root from this equation. See here. X into 3 minus x. From here 0 is coming. So there inequality sign is there. There is no equality sign.
So from the first condition, sir.
Yeah, from first condition 0 is not coming. 0 is not a root.
Okay.
First condition is this inside under root, whatever inside under root, everything must be greater than equal to 0.
Yes,
so I
sir.
Put this is greater than equal to 0.
Yes, sir.
The next condition, the base. This base is how much? 0.3.
Yes, sir.
So when I'm taking base, this inequality changing 0.3 raised to power 0.
Yes, sir. So that here only, sir, my question is in the blue equation which you have written, it should be is less than 3x minus x squared by x plus 1 is less than equal to 1. But in order 0 is less than. Sir, at the start, because that is the condition when the base is less than 1.
No, still I could not get you. One minute. What you are asking? From red, I am going this second, this
yes,
step
sir.
You are talking about,
yes,
I think.
Sir, that
okay.
step,
so in this step, see this now. Condition is, if you remember properly, next time I am going, condition was log AX greater than 0. Now case 1 or greater than anything. If x is base is less than 1 greater than 0, then my answer will be x is less than a raised to power 0. And second thing, if a log a x is greater than 0, a base is more than 1, then x is greater than a raised to power 0. So you can focus on this equality sign. This is here.
Okay.
Sign is changing.
Okay, sir.
Okay.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Okay, so everybody has noted this?
1 minute, sir.
Yeah. If base is greater than 1, Pritha, we can neglect the second part. No need, because then it will be more than 1. Yeah. Shall we proceed further? Okay, shall we proceed further? Everybody has noted?
Okay,
So Nidhi, now can you, I think my voice is better than previous. Just tell me, Nidhi. Okay. So now come to next. Now, very important question I'm taking of next type, different type, okay? Solve the equation four times of fraction part of x is equal to x plus greatest integer function x. This is greatest integer function, and this is a fractional part of x. Suppose this question is to be solved. Method I'm explaining. So what is the method? Different approaches will be there actually. In this question, first of all, I will eliminate the x. I know that this x is nothing but greatest integer function x plus fractional part of x. So I will write 4 fractional part of x is equal to this x. See, this x I'm going to replace. This is greatest integer function x plus fractional part of x plus greatest integer function x as it is. So now I will write 4 fractional part of x minus fractional part of x. 3 fractional part of x is equal to 2 times of greatest integer function of x. So afterward I can write that fractional part of x is equal to 2 greatest integer function x upon 3. This step is very, very important for this question. Afterward, we will solve from here. Now, the condition is left-hand side is equal to right-hand side, and we know left-hand side fractional part of x always varies between 0 to 1 as fractional part of x is always greater than 0, less than 1. So this implies that I can write this in this way. 2 greatest integer function x upon 3 must be always greater than 0, less than 3. Then only they can be equal, less than 1. So next step I can write 2 greatest integer function x is, I can multiply with 3, 0, less than 3. Or greatest integer function x is greater than 0 upon 2 and less than 3 upon 2. Now, what is this greatest integer function? GIF. This will be always integer. So between 0 and 3 I 2, what are the possible integer values? That we will write. So from this step, we will get, this implies that greatest integer function can be either 0 or 1. Because between 0 and 3 by 2, these are the only two integers available. So now we will split this question into two parts. Case 1, when greatest integer function is equal to 0. From the step 1, fractional part of x, using this step 1, this step. Fractional part of x is equal to 2 upon 3 into this step. So this will be equal to 0. So x will be how much? I know the fractional part. I know this both. So x, I know x is equal to x plus fractional part of x. And in this case, both are 0 plus 0 is equal to 0. So 0 is one of the solution. Second solution I will get, if I take greatest integer function is equal to 1, then fractional part of x will be 2 upon 3.
So x will be 1 plus 2 upon 3 is equal to 5 upon 3. So this equation, if the question is having two solutions, so x belongs to, you can write in this way also, this bracket, 0 comma 5 upon 3. So this equation is having two solutions. One is 0, another is 5 upon 3. Note down this. Afterward, if you have any doubt, you can ask me. So this is totally different model, different type of problem. Okay, Spurti. And Janvi also. See, this question is, I will take the blue pen, okay? Blue, not blue, yellow. 4 fractional part of x is equal to x plus greatest integer function of x. The concept in this question is, we will convert x into greatest integer function and fractional part of x by using this formula. X is equal to integral part plus fractional part. For example, any number, 3.8. You can write 3 plus 0.8. So integral part plus decimal part. Okay. So this is the next. This. Now, 4 fractional part of x. This is step x. This is the x. Plus greatest integer function x. So transfer this x. So 3 fractional part of x is equal to 2x. So from here, fractional part of x is equal to 2 upon 3, greatest integer function x. Now we know that fractional part of x always greater than equal to 0, less than 1. That condition we will put here. This is very, very important condition. Because right hand side must be equal to left hand side. For example, if right hand side is more than 4, 5, 6, it is not possible, then both cannot be equal. So 2 greatest integer function x upon 3 must be greater than 0 because these two are equal. Fractional part of x, I'm replacing here. Fractional part of x is equal to this much, so between 0 and 1. So now multiply by 3. So 2x lies between 0 and 3. So fractional part of this greatest integer function x lies between 0 and 3 by 2. Now the problem with greatest integer function is it can acquire only integral values. So between 0 and 3 by 2, you can see this is 0, this is 1, this is a 3 by 2, 3 by 2 is 1.5, this is 3 by 2. Only two integral values are there, that is 0 and 1, x. So I'm taking two integral values only, 0 and 1, greatest integer function. Then two cases are there separate. This is equal to 0, this is equal to 1, two separate cases. When this greatest integer function is 0, I will put in this greatest integer function is 0 in this equation, I will put and calculate. So fractional part of x is also 0. Second greatest integer function x equal to 1, then I will put here 1, I will get 2 upon 3. So this x is equal to, again in this equation, greatest integer function plus fractional part of x is equal to 5 upon 3. So these are two solutions. Okay. Now one or two questions I will take on period. So today is the complete revision what we have done. See, now I'm taking some questions on period. Periodic functions. y is equal to, one thing here you must learn, how to find period of composite functions. Note down this heading, period of composite functions. Certain guiding principles are there. Suppose I have y is equal to f of gx. So two conditions will be there. Case one, gx is periodic. Gx means inner function is periodic. Then it will be always periodic. Like y is equal to cos of sin x, or y is equal to log of sin x, always periodic. Second case is if gx is non-periodic and fx is periodic. See here, I have told in the first condition, fx may or may not be periodic. Fx may or may not be periodic. But in second case, gx is non-periodic and fx is periodic. Then it will be periodic if and only if, this is very important, if and only if gx is linear. Some examples I have given, like sine of x square plus 1. This is non-periodic. Here I have explained all these concepts. Sine of ax square plus bx plus c. Sine of 1 upon x. This sine of log x, these all are non-periodic functions. These are all non-periodic functions. This I have already given. Why they are non-periodic? Because gx inner function is this, these are not linear. Here it's under root, reciprocal function, quadratic function, that is the reason. Just note down, keep on writing.
See, there is too much traffic on the Zoom. That is why all these problems are coming. Zoom is getting hanged. Okay, so this is getting disconnected again and again. My flow is also broken in between. I have to start again. Period of composite functions. So as I told, if I have y is equal to f of gx, period of this will depend on f and g as well. Two cases will be there. First case, gx is periodic. Then f of gx is always periodic. Yeah. So I told A, f is even function, then period of g is supposed to be t by 2. But if then period of this f of gx will be t. Examples I have taken, so many examples we can take. Examples like y is equal to tan of sine x, or y is equal to sine cube x. This is also composite function. You can consider this as composite function, where fx is equal to x cube, gx is equal to sine x. So this function can be written as f of gx. Understood? So this is periodic function. Why? Because inner function gx is periodic, but its period will be defined by outer function. So what is outer function? This x cube. So in this case, period of sine x is only, in this case also period is 2 pi. But if you see another example, if I ask you period of y is equal to cos of sine x, cos of sine is equal to sine square x. See all these examples. In all these cases, if you observe here, this cos, work of, always remember, cos and mod. For example, cos of minus x also cos x, mod of minus x also. Similarly, for periodic functions, whenever cos is there, just replace by the mod, you will get the answer. So in this case, period of sine x is 2 pi, but this is even function. That means negative part will be made positive part. Same thing this mod will do. And same thing this square will do. So period of all the three functions is how much? T is equal to pi. You can see the difference. Yes, anybody? Any doubt in this? Anybody? Oh, so I'm taking small questions here. Next, please. Now, some questions I'm writing, you must be writing the period. Question number one, period of 3^ sine x. Question number two, y is equal to cos 10x. Question number three, y is equal to mod sine x plus mod cos x. Y is equal to mod sine x minus cos x. And question number five asked on Y is equal to cos sine x plus cos or cos x. Some questions I have written. Again, I have to write. First one was period of y is equal to three raised to power sine x. Second one, y is equal to, I don't know what was the question. N of cos x. Question number three, y is equal to mod sine x plus mod cos x. Question number four, mod sine x minus mod cos x. Question number five, cos sine x plus sine of cos. Last problem, question number six, y is equal to sine of cos x plus cos of 10x. Okay, one more question you can write. Y is equal to cos of 10x. Okay. Plus, then you just first everybody note down. This may get disrupted again.
Yes. You start giving me answer one by one. First question, let us discuss first. Y is equal to 3 raised to power sine x. What must be the answer of this? So first of all, you have to identify y is equal to 3 raised to power sine x. What kind of function it is? Inner function is sine x. If I give the value of x, first of all, sine x will take. So here fx is equal to 3 raised to power x, gx is equal to sine x. So this is periodic function because inner function gx is periodic. But this 3 raised to power x is not even function. So it will not affect its period. So my answer will be 2 pi. Answer in this case will be 2 pi. Some other examples you can have. Y is equal to e raised to power cos x. This also answer will be same. 2 pi. So both will have same answers. Next, 10 of cos x. Now this outer function 10. 10 is odd. So period will be again 2 pi. But in this case, this cos is even function. So it is very important. Here we have to check whether period will be pi or pi by 2 is also possible actually. Whenever you have doubt, you must always check. What is the method of checking? See here. Fx is equal to cos of 10x. Definitely period of 10x is pi. But question arises, can I use that concept? Because all those, whatever I have given oral guidelines, in this case, I will check whether pi by 2 is possible or not. Period can be pi by 2 or not. So if let t is equal to pi by 2, then what I will do? F of t plus x, pi by 2 plus x is equal to cos of 10 pi by 2 plus x. So this is equal to cos 10 pi by 2 plus x is minus cot x is equal to cos of cot x. So which is wrong? Which is not equal to fx. So in this case, period will be pi only, not pi by 2. That is why I have given this problem. Period will be pi only. Period will be pi only. See, one example I'm giving here on next page. Suppose you have fx is equal to cos of sine x. Now, period of sine x is 2 pi. So cos, sometimes it makes half, sometimes not. Suppose it is half, then we will check. F of pi plus x is equal to cos of sine of pi plus x. This is equal to cos of minus sine x, and cos of minus theta is cos of sine x. So this is how much? This is equal to fx. So f of pi plus x is equal to fx. This implies that period t is equal to pi. This is clear? Note down this. I will go to the previous page. Now, for this question number 3 and 4, I have given you one concept, if you have remembered. Question number 3 and 4. Okay. Shall I go to previous page now? See, this question number now, I'm explaining question number 3 and 4. For this, I have given you one concept that was A mod sin x plus B mod cos x, if you remembered. In the previous class, I told if fx is equal to A mod sin x plus B mod cos x. Case 1, if A is equal to B, period is a pi by 2. Case 2, if A is not equal to B, period is a pi. Note down this. This may be A sec x plus B cos x, or A tan x plus B cot x. All questions, this is the formula. So in this case, A is equal to B. So period will be pi by 2. Here A is equal to 1, B is equal to minus 1. So period will be pi. Now, for question number 5, one very simple thing I have told. Consider this cos as mod x. So this question is almost similar to mod of sin x plus mod of cos x. This cos works like mod. Cos of minus theta, cos theta. This is even function. So in this case also, your period will be what? Pi by 2. But question number 6. Hello? But question number 6 is a bit different and difficult. This I am explaining here. Next page, question number 6. Question is a period of sine of cos x plus sine of sin x. Sine of cos x plus sine of sin x. Definitely period of sin x and cos x is 2 pi. This we know. This period is 2 pi. This period is 2 pi. So now possibility is this period may be this or not. So if let t is equal to pi is period. Then f of pi plus x will be
sine of cos pi plus x such that this 2